I want to show you something. I want you to look at the screen. Look at my arm. This is real. I'm covered in goosebumps because this feels so damn good. Oh, trust me. We're going to get into some chants all night long. Trust me. Okay. Okay. Now this may come as a shock to a lot of people. Clearly somebody in the back. But I'm not here every single week. I was here every single week for years and years. That was my job, and I loved it. You see, The Rock was born and created here in the WWE. And I know this, this is my truth. If it weren't for the WWE and were not for all of you, The Rock would never exist. When I came back and said I was back and I was never going away, I meant it. Now, did it mean that I was gonna be back at every single Raw, every night, every SmackDown, every live event? No, that's not what it meant. And that was not what was ever expected. But if someone in the back, and you know who I'm talking to, wants to take that literally, then you go right ahead and you take it literally. Because unlike you, and you know who I'm talking to, I respect the audience's. Damn, I love that chant. I mean, really, that's a good one. Now, unlike you, I respect the audience's intelligence because they know that I was born in this business. And they know my heart and my soul is in this business. And they also know that I am standing in the middle of this ring right now in front of the world live for no other reason other than I love the WWE. And I will always be a part of the WWE, and the WWE will always be a part of me. John Cena. John Cena, you know, for years, I used to think that you were a phony. For years, I thought there was no way that the guy who graduated from private school all of a sudden became the doctor of thugonomics. He was from the streets, yeah. He was from the hood. But then I realized, John, you're not a phony. No. You are that guy. You're that guy who came out here last week and you ran me down. Even though I wasn't even in the building, you came out here, John. You're the guy who came out with all that passion and that anger. And you said you had to go through a wave of people just to get through to me. You couldn't talk to me directly. When the truth is, John, you have my cell phone number. You've called me before on it. But the ironic thing is, John, you see, I wouldn't even want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to you on my cell. I don't want to talk to you out in public. I don't want to talk to you back there. I didn't see you back there, John. I saw you. I see you in catering. I see you eating. Look, I don't want to talk to you. I would much rather slap your lying face with a piece of Kung Pao chicken. See, John, you're not a phony. I don't even think you're a bad guy. But what you are is a Kung Pao bitch. John, last week you said something. You said something that landed on me, and it resonated with me, John. It resonated with me. You said that come April 1st, you were gonna fight at WrestleMania for all the people in the back who love to be a professional wrestler. That's what you're gonna do, John. John, let me tell you something. I grew up in this business of professional wrestling. And I was always taught that there was no one who was ever going to fight for me. The only person who fights for you is you. That's how we learned, that's how we got better. No one fought for me. John, do you think when I was climbing the ladders, clawing, scratching the WWE, that someone was fighting for me? No. You think when I would come out to these arenas as a good guy, as a baby face, just like you, and they would boo me unmercifully, just like you, you think Stone Cold Steve Austin was fighting for me? No. Hell no. You think someone was fighting for Triple H, for Mick Foley, for Randy Macho Man Savage? You'll like this one. Do you think? Do you think that anyone fought for Rowdy Roddy Piper? No, hell no, 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 John, no. No one had to fight for us because we were men. But here's the thing, John, you want to fight for them in the back? That's fine. As a matter of fact, I prefer it. Because listen to me, John, listen to me. While you fight for them, I fight for them. You hear them, John? I fight for them. I fight for the people, the same people who are so sick and tired of having a Kung Pao bitch shoved down their throat every single night. By the way, Portland right now, trending worldwide, Kung Pao bitch. You see, John, you see, listen to them. Listen to them, John, because they're tired of you every single night. They're tired of you. They try and tell you every single night. But what they're not tired of, John, they're not tired of being entertained. And that's where I come in. That's where I come in. It's what I do. It's what I love to do. I love to entertain. I live to entertain in the middle of this ring. Movie screen, doesn't matter. I live to entertain. You see, John, every time we get together, The Rock and the people, we innovate, we break new ground, we trailblaze. When The Rock came back, and said, John Cena, you come out here and you look like a big fat bowl of Fruity Pebbles. What happened? This is what they did. They started chanting Fruity Pebbles, and then all of a sudden, we find your monkey ass on the cover of a cereal box. When The Rock came back and said, John, The Rock is gonna take his size 15 boot and stick it right up Cena's lady parts. What happened, John? They started chanting lady parts and then trending worldwide. Boom. You're welcome, bitch. A second. What we got? We got half the crowd chanting Rocky and the other half chanting lady parts. Which one do you want to chant? Okay, I tell you what we'll do. I mean, we're split 50-50. How about this? On the count of three, let's do lady parts. One, 2, 3. Okay, now we can chant my favorite on the count of three. Let's go ahead and chant Rocky. 1, 2, 3, and... You see, John Cena, you're back there now. I want you to listen to him. What we do, we have fun. We entertain. We innovate. What's the most innovative thing that you've done all year, John? Oh, I'll tell you what you did. You changed your jean shorts to camouflage shorts. Yeah. But here's the thing. I'll tell you right now, that camouflage is working, Jack. Because I speak for everyone here and everyone around the world to say, we can't find your balls whatsoever. By the way, here's how we're gonna make history again. Right now, again, Portland, Oregon. Cena's missing balls trending worldwide. John.
whoa. This is too much fun. I was not going to miss this. I mean, you actually referred to me as Kung Pao Chicken. Kung Pao Chicken. Only The Rock could refer to me as Kung Pao Chicken. It's genius. It's absolutely brilliant. Because every single Chinese restaurant you go to, it's always there. It's perfect, Rock. And this is perfect Rock. The Rock comes out, does his shtick, holds the millions in the palm of his hand like only The Rock can do. But I must admit, I didn't come out here to swing from the people's strudel or whatever you call on your penis nowadays. I came out here to tell you you were right. You're right, I am that guy. I'm the guy who runs you down when you're not here. But as usual, just like everything else, you're only half right. Because I'm the guy that runs you down when you are here. You see, these people love The Rock. I was one of these people until I got to meet Dwayne Johnson. Dwayne Johnson is a self-centered, egotistical, see-through son of a bitch. That wouldn't give a rat's ass if this company closed its doors tomorrow. Now I'll tell you something, Jack. I don't need words like respect and loyalty to trend worldwide. Just like I don't need my notes for my promo on my wrist. Nice tattoo. So here's the skinny. April 1st, when the millions see John Cena versus The Rock, John Cena is gonna be eyeing up Dwayne Johnson. And I don't like Dwayne Johnson. You probably make your boobs bounce. There'll be a thing on your eyebrow that looks like the people's eyebrow. But I'm gonna be looking into the eyes of Dwayne Johnson and see a man afraid. Because you're gonna be looking at a dude who may not have balls, but a dude who is gonna beat the hell out of you at WrestleMania, Jack. Oh, carry on, continue trending.
It's like you, John. It's like you to come out, run your mouth, and then walk away before I slap the lips off your face. But I tell you what, it doesn't surprise me you come out here, now you confuse the world, you don't like The Rock, you like Dwayne Johnson, hate Dwayne Johnson, what you got? Let me tell you something, John, you're back there listening right now. You're back there listening right now. Let me tell you this, John, The Rock, Dwayne Johnson. Dwayne Johnson, The Rock. That is the same man in here is the exact same man out there. The exact same man, the exact same man, John. But the difference between me and you, you come out here, you run your mouth about being tough, you ain't tough. I know it and you know it. The bottom line is this, The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, The Rock, the people's champ, the great one, the most electrifying man in all of entertainment. It doesn't matter, John. It doesn't matter. The only thing that matters, and you're back there listening, is that what I'm going to do on the biggest stage of WrestleMania, the biggest match of all time, The Rock, all the nicknames you want to throw, Team Bring It Worldwide, we're going to kick your candy ass all over WrestleMania. If you submit.